Ralph out of this. Okay, so I've got some Ralph the Baptist story out with. I'm going to say most women, there are some men. There's a beautiful earring that was found in the parking lot. It's a little flower with a diamond in the middle. Anyway, so if anybody lost an earring, I don't want to leave nobody out. So that's why I'm asking everyone. So Jerry, can this get you this? Okay, could have been. But anyway, we're just, it's here. Let's start with a word of prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you again for this privilege in your house. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for each and every one that's out this morning. Lord, it's good to see this wonderful crowd. I thank you for this beautiful sunshine, Lord, of ours singing. And just singing your praises, how good you are. God, we love you. And Lord, if there's anyone here that has a need this morning, Lord, to bring it to you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. All right, Terry's going to be a little more than myself here this coming week. And he requested that he play a song with us. You know we can't say no, right? I mean, anytime Terry volunteers to play the harmonica, you got to let him go. So we're going to open up this morning before we get into our hymns. All that stuff, we're going to sing a song called 1500 Miles Off.
It's coming down. Amen.
My dad's been sick for a couple weeks. He's in the
lost recently, both of family, and then the people in Mississippi. Their mom's family, lost a teacher this week. And so I'm probably be here today or next week. Their mom.
Any others? That's covered, Sister Judy, it's good. It's good to have her here this morning. She's fighting a battle right now. Also, the Lawrence family is so quiet, I know, that God is all about, God's everywhere. Also, it's been a little Jim, he's not feeling well this morning. God lift him up this morning. I know God's able to do all that. That's a lot of it.
I'd like for the church to remember where my daughter came with and my family that's unsafe.
Yeah, one's under the weather this morning, she's just in her chest. And I pray for her, my college roommate, Tom Banda. Was back in the hospital with another round of pneumonia, but is back out again. So praise the Lord for that and pray for my young friend, Justin Chambers, for salvation.
Any others?
Let's pray for Carolyn. Carolyn's not feeling well today. And she wasn't feeling well yesterday either. Last week she was doing really great because they took her off some of her medicine and she felt better than she's felt in forever. But now it's going the other way, so we need to take care of that.
It's also a member of Carolyn's wife who's been down. Louisiana?
Yeah.
And, she's going to be operating for her. Quite good. Okay, so let's lift that family up also. As you remember my mom also, we're still fighting battles with her, but she called 911 this week, whatever, her mom was out. She called her nurse and said, she's staying with her brother in my sister's house right now. She's not real happy about that, but we have to do something now, so I asked you all, more anything that God gives us wisdom, that we destroy the way that we need to go. For everybody. Any unspoken requests with hands? Let's all stand for prayer. Brother Ken, I'm going to introduce you, brother.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thank you, Jesus, that you are El Shaddai, the mighty God. Thank you that you are the Redeemer of our souls. You are the maker and creator of heaven and earth. We pray, dear God, for all of these requests this morning, for each one. We especially lift up the 26 of that have been lost down in Mississippi and their families, dear Lord, as they've lost these loved ones. We pray for them. Give them peace and give them a courage and help them through this time of turmoil. We pray, dear God, for all of the requests that have brought forth this morning. We pray for Jim. We pray for Judy. We pray for Greg's mother. We pray for Lori. We pray for Carolyn and others, dear Lord, names that I cannot remember right now. We pray that you touch each one and bless them. We cast all our cares upon you, for you care for us. And now, especially this morning, dear Lord, we pray for the lost, for men and women, boys and girls throughout the world who do not know you as Lord and Savior. We lift them up to you. We pray for all the missions, dear Father, that so faithfully proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. We pray for our church this morning, that you touch Brother Gray as he brings the message. May it touch our hearts and draw us ever so closer to the Lord Jesus Christ. Bless us now and be with us in the wonderful, precious, and blessed name of Jesus. Amen and amen.
Let's all stand.
Let's all stand.
us, which says we've gone through so many trials. But God's grace has brought me through every one of them. I'm not going to lie, it hurts sometimes. Sometimes it's confusing, we don't understand.
Once again, we thank you, Lord, for your presence that's here this morning. We just thank you for that most of all, foremost. Lord, as we come to taking up this morning tithes and offering, we just pray that you just bless it, Lord, use it for your kingdom, that many souls will come in, Lord, to get to know you. And Lord, each and every one that's able to give this morning, and the ones that can, we just pray that you bless them also. But most of all, Lord, we thank you again and be with the remainder of the service. And just let your Holy Spirit continue as well, Lord. We give you your praise for it.
So we're going to try a song we've never done before. We worked on it yesterday, so hope and pray this works out okay. But Pastor Greg heard a song on the radio that really touched him and ministered to him. It's called No Longer Slaves. And it basically talks about that if you understand who you are in Christ, I'm no longer a slave to fear. I don't have to be afraid of God. I can come to Him boldly before His throne of grace to obtain help in my time of need. Amen. So we hope and pray that this song is a blessing to you. If you know the words, we hope and pray you'll sing and worship God together with us.
Let us sing.
put him on the spot. We don't have him here, but you have a phone for us this morning. No, okay. Dave, you all, Brother Dave, you all have a phone. Just wanted to use you.
Sing this morning. My sinuses have been all over the place with the weather, so just listen to the words and just pray for us.
I remember how you told me that life may not be easy, and everything that I need, you've already given me. Told me I can trust you completely. So why am I doubting when you prove that you fight for me? You've walked me through fire.
Oh,
I know he'll get us through it. Doesn't make it any easier. But just pray for me that I'll be able to just make it through this song. I've never sung it out, but it's one of my favorite songs.
No matter what, we have to realize that we have to do that for him.
because look what he done for us. And yes, it hurts. Absolutely, honey. I know it has to be tearing your heart out. But there is a reason, and God will bless you through this. He will. And we just have to keep on striving. Just stick by the Lord and don't walk away from Him. By all means, don't walk away from the Lord, no matter what happens in your life. Because I know sometimes things like this happen and you think, what the heck? How can He even care for me if He does something like this to me? That is not the thing. We have got to stick closer and closer to Him. I love everybody. God bless you, God, honey. Something good will come out of this. Just got to praise God no matter what.
I've been stoned on this message for quite a while. And I'm going to pick a different direction. The only thing I've studied in front of the field is went out the weather. And God put this over us. The Bible says back in St. John in the 14th chapter, it says, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, and believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. Go through my tears. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Father in heaven, Lord, I thank you today for what you mean to me. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for your presence that we feel this morning. Lord, this morning there's so many hearts that are broke this morning. And Lord, you know all about each and every one of them. Lord, those that came this morning not feeling well, Lord, I ask you, Lord, to lift them up. Lord, those that's here have a need, I ask you, Lord, that they bring it to you. Father, we do love you, we do thank you. And in Jesus' name we pray. And amen.
Always hit the nail on the head this morning. She said, you're justified, baby. But you all know in my house, it's just where it is.
You know, I've been studying about not being that perfect Christian. You know, sometimes in life we strive to do everything that we can do possible to make everything right for everyone else. And sometimes you can't control that. No matter how hard you pray, no matter how hard you strive, sometimes you can't control the outcome of what things happen. I'm so glad I serve a God that understands. I'm so glad he understands Greg's failures, his faults, his mistakes. We're striving to do so much for him. But I look around the crowd this morning, charging. We have a lot of people that are heartbroken this morning. If it was us to us, this would never happen on all of us, every account that today and this morning. But no matter how hard we strive, God has control of it. I'm so glad this morning, Lord, He is the author. I'm glad to know this morning, Lord, no matter what we go through and what we are struggling through this morning, Lord, God has an answer. Do you realize this morning, Lord, He is your only answer? Through all the problems of life, through everything that we go through this morning, Lord, God is your only answer. I thank God about seeing Shelby, Brother Derek, coming this morning. They don't know how much they mean to us. I talked to Derek quite a bit at work. I tried not to bug him too much because, see, I once we talk about God, I point away from his job. And because it ain't a 5 minute talk conversation, usually it's 20 to 25 minutes because we get talking about the Lord. But truly, there's nothing better that I want to talk about than my Lord. There's nothing better than nature for each and every one of us this morning. I don't care what you're going through. God is your answer. I'll go back to that. It says here that not your heart be troubled. Today, Jonah, he knows what you're going through. He knows the problems in your life. He knows the struggles that you're having today, Jonah. He says to cast our cares upon him. So many times, Jonah, we try to carry that load by ourselves. We're guilty Christians. Every one of us sitting here, we are guilty of trying to carry that by ourselves. And he just sat there with open arms saying, child, why not give it to me? Why not give me that care? Why not give me that trouble? Why not give me that burden that you're going through? And let me carry it for you. You know, today, Jordan, I think about this scripture here where it says it. You know how well that word is when Christ was talking. You know, I can imagine him when he looked at all his crowd. And you think about today, Jordan, that everyone that followed the Lord. Now, that's what I was preaching on actually this morning. And maybe this is all coming together. I don't know. God knows what he's doing right now. I thought about Judas. He walked with the Lord. He walked with Jesus daily. Daily. And sin got in. The Bible says, children, in Luke, the 21st chapter, second chapter, bear with me. I know this is going to like my eyes open. It says there in the 22nd chapter, the third verse, says, then entered Satan into Judas, surnamed Iscariot, being in the number of 12. And he went his way and communed with the chief priests and captains how he might betray him unto them. Church, this is one of the 12. This is one of the 12 that walk with Jesus every day. He's seen him heal the blind. He watched him heal the deaf man. Numerous times, lame man. Numerous times, the blind man. The lepers come to Jesus. And just the very speaking of the name, he healed them. Judas walked with him on this. Judas seen this every day, church. And this is what I say about that perfect Christian. There's none of us this morning that are perfect. Every one of us this morning, Jordan, I want to let you know, you strive, the Bible says we should strive to be the best Christian that we could. Because what are we supposed to do? We are supposed to live our life like Jesus. That's what our mirror image is supposed to be. We are supposed to try to be like them. But today, Jordan, every one of us, we're human. Every one of us today, Jordan, we fail. Every one of us today, Jordan, we come up short. Jesus understands that. God understands that. He understands we're still human. We're still carnal. And he understands that we are going to make a mistake. But I thank God this morning I serve a merciful God that forgives me of my mistakes. I thank God this morning, John, that I serve a God that when rain comes up short, he picks me up and he leads me on through it. But this morning here, children, Judas... Bible says, children, in that third verse, and I underlined that, it says, then entered Satan. Then entered Satan into Judas. Church, he was a child of God. He was one of his 12 disciples that was probably, if you want to look at it today, children, he was one of those one in that elite group. But the devil got in. And I say to say this, church, we strive. And we should. Every one of us should strive to be the best Christian that we could be. I told Jill many times that if Greg dies, he goes on to be with the Lord. Only thing I want in my casket is someone to be able to look down and say he loved the Lord. That he loved the Lord. That he knows best for the Lord. That church has my goal. I don't know how it is with your life. It should be your goal today, children, to do to strive to be the very best that you can be for him. Every one of us today, when you go to your job or whatever, and then someone you do your very best, when you go out, and I'll pick on some of you guys here to go out and play golf at this point. I always told my different ones, but my daddy. I told him, I said, Dad, I just can't understand how someone can take that white ball, lay it on the ground, hit it, then walk after it. I just never understood that. But you know, as I got older, softball don't come along like it used to be. You can't move like you used to move. You don't run for first. You know, I remember hitting a gapper, and you know, when that ball got between first and second, I would be on second base where they got the ball there. Now I struggle to get to first base. I don't even try for second base. Man, that's for all you old young people. This boy ain't going that direction. But I'd say to say this, life changes. And I say, I go back to the golf. You know, my brother got me into this. Greg, oh, you'll love it. See, I hear people laughing. That's part of what's in play. Because what I've learned about golf is one hole, you'll be all excited. But that next hole, you wish you never picked a club up because you're like, why in the world happened? And my brother always said, well, Greg, and again, it's just great. Continue to swing the softball. I want to pick my foot up to swing. And my brother would get on me and go, but I go back and say this. I never was good at it. And the reason being why I never strived to be. I didn't strive to be. It wasn't Greg's love. Basketball, yeah, I ain't broke his love. But it come a time in life that Greg no longer do that. God was my grandbabies. But I strived at that time. But one thing in my life, church, that Greg is still able to do from a young age all the way to 64 years old, is I can still serve God. And I still strive to do the best that Greg can do. I fail. I'm not that perfect Christian. I'm telling you, church. Judas, I go back to Judas. Him and his other 11 elite walked all over the seas of Galilee, walked through Jerusalem, Nazareth, all over the place, healing, saving everyone that they spoke to. But the Bible says that Satan entered in. You go back to Job. The Bible says that God said that Job was one of his best Christians. I'm using Greg's words here. And all of a sudden, everything that the old devil come along, and he told him, he said, God, and can you imagine talking to God this way? The old devil looked at God and said, you know, you pull your hands away from him, and he'll curse you just like everyone else does. Within days, old Job, one of the richest men in his time, lost everything that he had, including his family. But he still strived to serve God. He still strived to serve the Lord. Church, I'm telling you today, children, you're going to go through the obstacles, you're going to go through tribulations. But we're no different than those here in the Bible. Strive to be that perfect Christian. Strive to love the Lord. Oh, Peter. Jesus looked at him and they were sitting there waiting at the table. And Jesus looked at Peter. Can you imagine that? Yeah. None of the 12. This is where I'm going, church. We're not perfect Christians. We need to strive. We need to work at it. Every day is a job. Every day we ought to work to do the best that we can do for the Lord. Jesus looked at Peter and he told him, "You're going to deny me." Think about it. Peter said, "Well, Lord, there's no way. You're my first love. I love you with all that I have." And Jesus says, "You're going to deny me three times." Set me at the table. The very last time that we'll be together, 12 of them. The one sitting right next to Jesus is the one that's betraying him. And Jesus knows this. But his love that he has, and this is why God loves us so much. His mercy and his love is why we're saved this morning. But for his love, with this one right now, you all think about this. Think about it in your life. If it was you, and you have someone sitting next to you that you knew without a shadow of doubt that he was going to betray you, how would you feel? Would you be able to hold that love that Jesus had? Or would you want to look at him and say, "Leave, get away from here. I don't know your thoughts. I don't know what you're going to do." But because the love and mercy that Jesus had for each and every one of us, not only his 12 disciples, church, this goes for every one of us this morning. Because of God's love this morning, children, he continues to forgive us. And he continues to love us. Through all of our shortcomings, through all our faults, through all of our mistakes, God still loves us. You realize that this morning, church? No matter what you're going through, I don't care what trial you have, I don't care what stipulation you're in right now, God still loves you.
Right.
And if you cast your cares upon him and you bring it to him, he will take care of that. Yes, can he stop things from happening? Sure, God can. But I remember a story in the Bible where the disciples looked at Jesus and he says, "Was the parents something wrong with the parents? Were they bad? Did they go against the law? Did they go against God? Is why their child was blind?" And Jesus says, "No. It's for my God to be glorified." Church, we're not perfect Christians. And if you sit here, that is, I'd like to shake your hand. Because I've not met one of them yet, all my years. But I just say I've met a lot of loving Christians that love the Lord that are striving to go to the same place that I'm trying to go to. And that's both of the Lord. The Bible says here that Jesus looked at Peter and he told him that he was going to deny me. Of course, Peter denied it. Imagine that. Jesus said he's going to deny it. He denied it that it's going to happen. But the Bible says when they took Jesus, and Judas betrayed him, one of the 12. And they come and they took Jesus and they walked him away. That very same day, the second of the 12 denied him. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, we also today, children, there's a lot of things that we're going through. And this morning, if you're sitting here and you know this God that I'm talking about, wonderful. Thank you, good Lord. Just strive. It's a job. It's a job, church. Every one of us have a job to do. If you're saved this morning, you have a job. And that is to live your life to the best for him. Do your best, will. I have loved ones that are saved, church. I'm sure every one of you sitting here this morning could probably think of someone close to your family or even a friend that needs help. So, church, we got to strive. I'm not saying strive to be perfect. I'm saying strive to live for him. Because until we go to be with the Lord, there's none of us who want to be perfect. None. No, not one. But I know one. There's a song that Sister Sydney and Judy used to sing, and as a matter of fact, they probably still sing it. And you know, some call him Satan, but I call him friend. The church I say to say this, he could be that friend that's sticking closer than a brother. Through all the troubles and trials that you go through life, I know one that can. I ask you this morning, children, to give it to him. You can't carry that burden alone, church. You can't carry it. Those we're in this old human body down here, we are not able to carry that load. But I know one who can. This morning, as the singers come, if you're sitting back here this morning and you have a need, this altar is open. You're more welcome to come and pray and give it to him. If you don't want to get up out of your seat and you want to pray, be glad to come back and pray with you. So as we stand here this morning, children, and they come and sing, let's all stand, please. If you have a need, I ask you to bring it to God. Because we know God is in it. Love you, Lord. You know what's happening.
Thank you.
like the Brother Jim, Sister Judy, like everyone that believes in healing. We have to pray for you guys. So you just sit there and we'll come to you, Brother Jim. Sister Judy, we just don't want
to. Let's get Carolyn there too.
Please.
Let's do Carolyn too.
Sister Carolyn also, yes. Church, if you believe in healing this morning, I ask everyone to come around and I ask you to bow your heads and pray. We know God is a risen Savior. Today, children, that can do the most as possible. Music and get saved. You know, I can't. You know what the heaven's going to be like?
I wouldn't miss it. I pray you would either. All hearts clear before we're dismissed. Okay, as we dismiss. Sister Cindy, as you dismiss.